The first Bitcoin, like I used to work like in computer parts, and a lot of my partners, like business partners, were actually mining it, and they used to mine it with like very basic equipment. Actually, like in a very short period, they mined 5 Bitcoins, and I just wanted to buy some just to place that order, and there was like in the whole city, like looking up like online on the internet, there was just like one person, like his name. 5 Bitcoins for $300. And that's how I first met him. I just tried to figure out how to make a wallet. Yeah. His store name was Zagao, and he used to sell like gold over there and silver. And Bitcoin was just like he was the only guy in the city who really had it. Kijiji, just searching around Kijiji, and all like my computer nerd friends, like they only knew that guy. They're like, yeah, you just go to like he'll hook you up. At first, he had like some office, like in some very old building that they just tore down already. But then it started like getting bigger and bigger for him, and like he kept like expanding. Then he just gets like a full area, gets more and more workers. And actually, I remember the first time he was very like worried, because a lot of people could be trying to Bitcoin for to do something like very illegal or dangerous. I think 2012. I did that 2012, I believe. And I was dealing with him for like a long period, like after, until I became like decided to be like a broker myself. And many times they keep banning me, investing me with the fraud department, laundering department, until they banned me. Until I got banned by each bank account, each bank in Canada. I open banks everywhere, Western Union, MoneyGram, even in the U.S. Like I'm just banned everywhere. Like it's very hard, like I don't have a bank card, it's very hard to do anything now. But later, it was easy to find. Like now you can buy Bitcoin from, like there's every convenience store nearby. Like there are like 5 Bitcoin ATMs just walking distance from me now.